Well, first of all, welcome to K-State. And I think the thing that most fans want to know is going from in-conference one school to another is somewhat unusual, but what was it about K-State that attracted you the most?
Well, the list is pretty long. So, first, it's a program with a tremendous tradition, tremendous history, tremendous fan base. The arena we're sitting in, when this place is packed, I don't know if there's one louder. So all those things are exciting for me. And in women's basketball, there aren't a lot of those situations. So it's unique in that. So that passion right away drew me. The other stuff is it's an area of the country I'm familiar with and grew up in. And my wife's from Junction City and I'm from Kansas City. So you tie in all those things and you say, boy, this could be a really good fit. So, the other thing that I would say is in evaluating the team, this is a team with a lot of young talent. And this is a team that I think has tremendous potential. So I already have scouting reports on them. I've watched a ton of film. So it is unusual to go interconference. There are some advantages to that. I certainly know the league and know how tough it is.
Recruiting wise, I mean, you've clearly had some great success at TCU with young players. You went through this process with a young team last year and had the turnaround this year of such a great, great team. Recruiting ties to Texas clearly seem to be an advantage, and this place at K-State also seems to be a good pipeline to Texas. Was that also an attractive
place? No doubt. They've got some Texas players on the roster, and it's an attractive place to kids from Texas. So I see our recruiting being widespread, but also we've got to get the best players in Kansas. And then Texas is always going to be a recruiting place for Kansas State, but it's also going to be a recruiting place for everybody.
What would you tell the fans about your style of basketball? Are you a coach that subscribes to this is the way we're going to play and I find players to fit that system, or are you a coach that adjusts based on the type of talent you may have?
Well, I've had to adjust at times, and when we came into the Big 12, I had to adjust some things because coming out of the Mountain West, it was not as physical of a league and certainly wasn't played at the level that the Big 12's played at. Offensively, I prefer players to make plays, so I prefer motion offense. Defensively, I've played both man, and that's the area that I think I am more flexible with our group. If I see us fitting better in an area, then we'll make some switches defensively. And we were top 20 in the league defensively last year, or top 20 in the country. And then offensively, we were a struggle, but we found a way to play, I think, efficient basketball. But I like players to make plays. I like motion offense. I like isolation stuff. I like this team. I already have a vision for what I want to do with this basketball team. And quite frankly, I can't wait to do that part of the job. This is okay, but I love doing that part of the job. And I love already having a vision as opposed to coming in here in the spring and trying to get to know their basketball talents. I feel like I already have that vision, and it may change a little bit, but hopefully I have a pretty good feel already.
Most Wildcat fans that were excited and were here in the building watching this team play were very excited about the freshman class, and you've already spoken to it as we've sat here, but a Letty Romero, a Kindred Wiesman, and even a Bree Lewis at her height at 6'5". What specific attributes of those players or the freshman girls do you like the most as you look forward?
Yeah, I like Wiesman's shooting ability and toughness. That kid slid into the scorer's table more than any player I saw all year. Love those things about her. Letty Romero, I think, has tremendous vision. She's got a really good feel. She reminds me of a point guard I had from Iceland, and a good-sized point guard. She's a player that when we watched her on tape, we thought, this is a mismatch nightmare. I think we can use her in that. And I thought the most improved player from game one of conference to game 18 of conference might have been Bree Lewis. So those three are pretty good freshman starting blocks there. I thought Jessica did some good things. I thought there were just good things across the board from the young players. And, it's not just the young ones either. There are some veterans here that have some savvy to them. And so I see this as a total team. They had to take some lumps this year, but it looks bright going forward, and that's why I'm here.
Lastly, I guess you would talk about just the overall package of Kansas State, and clearly when you and TCU had the same thing when you were there, and you're well versed with that. A successful football program and men's basketball and all those sorts of things, the passion of K-State fans. I guess you've only been here a short amount of time, but what has struck you about not just women's basketball but all of Kansas State since you've been here?
I tell you, I'm amazed at the family atmosphere, and a lot of people throw that around, and we have received more text from coaches' wives, and that's before we got here. You walk in and the event, the players, most of them were able to come back on their spring break. You had like a reception line in there for a wedding, you know, of people that care deeply about Kansas State. Those type of things are things that you can just feel are genuine. And, you know, people in the Midwest know when you're not genuine. That's the thing I love about Kansas. I love about the Midwest, and that's just something that I think is really, really special.
Coach, appreciate the time. Thanks
All
for
right,
doing
thank
this.
Thank you.